Hello YouTubers, in this video we will see three things. First one, we will find out a simple under voltage protection for the solar panel. Number two, we will measure the solar output current. Number three, we will measure output ripple voltage. When the solar charge current fluctuates, we will see how the voltage fluctuates. Let's get started with this. The basic setup is like this: solar panel, charge controller, and goes to the battery. This charge controller, it can provide over voltage protection, but it doesn't have the under voltage protection. That means this battery, from the battery, if you take power to the microcontroller, we can straight away connect, and the regulator provide 3.3 volt. That's okay, but it doesn't have under voltage protection. If it goes below 3 volt, it will still take the current and it will damage the battery. For that, I bought this one from the eBay, and it's a power bank without the battery. What we can do is we put the battery here and give the power and charge here, and we take from this one. If you take the power, this one has under voltage protection. Let's put the battery and see. Now I have placed the battery here and give the connection here. Now it can charge and we can get the power. This one provide over voltage protection, this one provide under voltage protection, and it also boost it up for 5 volt. If we need some 5 volt supply as well, we can take it from here. And when we connect to the microcontroller, the regulator in the microcontroller, the regulator here, it will take to 3.3 volt. Now another good thing is that we have enough room here. If we put one more battery here, we have enough room to keep the microcontroller here. We can keep this place in here. We have enough room, and the case is here, and we can close it. Let's go outside and do the measurement test. Today is a clear day in one of the winter day, and when we see, the sun is over there somewhere. And when you come back to the solar panel, it's here and goes through the amp meter and goes to the battery. You see, it is 165 milliamp. Now I have the setup like this. The solar panel is here, other side, and I put two more batteries, and still about 135 milliamp. Now I have 10 ohm load. 10 ohm load. I need to connect to the power supply. Now it's connected, and power is 137. When you go to the oscilloscope, it's around 5 volt. The division is 1 volt division. It's in the 5 volt. The ripple is only a little bit, and I put the hand and I cover the solar panel like this and see the ripple. Now I'm covering. Not much ripple, it's around 5 volt when we see the values. Now I have connected the power supply to the microcontroller, and the oscilloscope I connected to 3.3 volt regulated power. When we go here, this is how the
waveform look like? There's not much ripple in it. It's around 3.3 volt. When I cover the solar panel like this, and you see the oscilloscope. Now I'm covering and taking it out. The waveform is looking like this. I will put the picture of the waveform in the description website.
Now the power calculation is, the maximum current is 166 milliamp. So the output power is current multiplied by volt. It's 4.2 volt. So it's 697 milliwatt. I measured the length and width of the solar panel. Width is 6 centimeter. Length is 11 centimeter. So its area is 66 square centimeter. So output power is power divided by area. It's about 10.5 milliwatt per square centimeter. Now for the ripple, I have taken the picture of the oscilloscope. So the 0 volt is here. It's 1 volt division. So it's 5 volt here. So the 1 volt division is here. So I zoom this area. I zoom it more. So it's here. So the 5 volt is here. When I measure these dots, there's 25 divisions. 3 division is here. Sorry, 2 division is here. So 2 divided by 25 multiplied by 1 volt. The ripple is 0.08 volt. That's 80 millivolt. So the top line is 5.0 volt. The bottom line is 4.96 volt. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, please type it in the comments below. Please like, subscribe, and share. Thank you.